question was, what should I do? I want to exit the country, but my sponsor still has my passport over 8 months now since he ran away and his ID is expired. So, my friend, the first thing, you need your passport for you to travel. You will never travel without your passport because your QID is expired. So the first thing is go to your sponsor. You have no option, and ask them for the passport. The passport is your right. This one, remember, passport is your right. Your sponsor is not supposed to keep your passport in Qatar without your permission. That's according to the Qatar labor law. And if you report your sponsor to the government, you'll have to pay 25,000 riyal as fine. But again, why did you run away? And why have you been in Qatar illegally for over 8 months? So that raises the question, because your sponsor can go and raise a case against you, maybe say you did something wrong and all that. So this one, you really have to talk well, nicely with your sponsor. And more so this time of Eid, you could have taken advantage of this Eid and Ramadan, because this is the month that they can, you know, it's a holy month, and maybe the sponsor can forgive you and give you the passport. So a tough situation indeed. The second one is, I only received the OTP and my PRO said the application has been submitted successfully, so I'm not gonna wait for the second message. Yeah, it's true. Nowadays, there's no receiving of the second message. Once your PRO applies for you, the EC number comes on the in the submission box, then you receive the EC. So nowadays, do not expect the second message to tell you your application has been submitted successfully. There's no second message. And there's a third question, which is EC number. So this guy is asking, what do I need to attach when I'm going to a Delisa or Alcohol branch to make a follow-up? So write the EC number on the screenshots of your, you know, you have the EC number, either you have taken a screenshot of it or you have it. You can just write it on top of the scanned QID. And if you have to write a letter to just write that you're following up, you can also do that. So once you are submitting at the security, just tell them you are doing a follow-up, because it has taken a long time and you've been waiting for approval all this time. Next person here is asking, I have an existing contract and I want to come to Qatar because I got a new visa. So this guy is Indian. He got a new job offer in Qatar, but the visa processing has been difficult because his former employer did not cancel the contract. Like, his visa is still online and his contract has not been canceled by the former employer. What should he do? This is my advice to you, but disclaimer, I'm not a criminal, I'm a good guy. So my advice to you, I hope it works for you too, just change your passport. That's all. Change your passport so that when they will be applying for a visa, it will be coming with a new passport number. So because the visa that is existing in the system, it's with your current passport. So just get a new passport to be having a new passport number. Yeah. Toodles. Okay. Then there is number 5 is asking, is it possible for me to cancel my application before it's approved? Since I applied, it has been so long and I want to continue with my current company since the approval is not coming. How do I go about it? You can decide and do nothing, because if you do nothing, still your sponsorship remains with your current employer. Or if you want to insist, you can go and cancel on at least, you need to make a follow-up with a cancellation request letter. Then they will cancel for you. But though there's no big deal, you can just leave it, because it's not gonna change to a new sponsor if you don't complete the whole process. So your sponsor will still be your sponsor, so you really don't have to do anything. And then there is another guy asking also, he applied before it to another company, but now he has lost interest on that company and he wants to cancel and apply with a different company. Is that possible? Yes, but the whole process, man, trust me, it's hectic. It's really hectic. But if you go to at least an Alcor branch after this Eid holiday, go there and tell them you just want to cancel the application. Canceling takes just 3 to 4 hours as long as you go to Alcor branch. And as I told you guys, the best way to go to Alcor branch right now is take a metro bus to Lusail station. From Lusail station, take an Uber. It will be 40 real. And if you are more than one person, you can share the price, which will make it even more cheaper, 20 real or 15 real, depending on how many you are. And go and make that follow up. Just have a letter showing, a letter in Arabic written that you want to cancel the release application, the change of employer application. Attach it with your QID and the EC number. EC number is very important because it's the one that will track your information. Plus, don't forget to write your phone number. That one is also very, very, very important. So, yeah, there's a guy also who is asking me, like, do I need to give my original NOC letter and my original resignation to the company? No. When you are applying for anything in Qatar or even outside Qatar, please don't apply with your original documents. Have copies, scan, print a copy and apply with it. You need to keep the originals for your future reference or for your future use. Okay, so guys, now I'm going to answer that person who was asking, how much am I being paid and what kind of job do I do in Qatar? Number one, I work in the hospitality industry. If that's what you wanted to know, I've been working in the hospitality industry for more than four years. I started with Subway restaurant, I went to Intercon, I went to Mövenpick, I worked in Jordan in a five-star resort. I worked in some restaurant in Pearl, Qatar, and then I worked in McDonald's. Yeah, right now I'm working in a certain company. Of course, for those who know this building, I always post it is the, among the tallest buildings in Qatar. So this is where I'm currently working. What kind of job? You can continue guessing, but it's not... Yeah, I'm not going to say anything. And about my salary, I don't think whether my salary, if I mention it, it's gonna help you in any way. So my salary is just my salary. Yeah, and I don't see any reason as to why I should publish my salary. So guys, my salary is for me and my family. It will not help you, sorry. But just know in Qatar, no one earns less than 1,000 Qatar riyal because that's the minimum wage. So people earn up to 8,000 to 5,000 Qatar riyal depending on what you're doing on which company. But your salary is your salary and it can be huge or small depending on how much responsibility you have back in your home country or you have for yourself. If you have no responsibilities, that's too much money. If you have too much responsibility, that's nothing, man. We are never satisfied with money. But definitely, as you all know, if you're working in the Middle East, you can never be paid enough to exit forever, but you can be paid something that can sustain you so that you continue working to get more and more. Yeah, if we were being paid an amount of money that is enough, then you will be paid once and leave to go to your country because no one, of course, wanna stay here forever. Everyone wants to work, make some progress back at home and go back home to join their families. So see you in the next one. Follow me on Instagram at VicSizzle. And yeah, that's it. Peace out. See you in the next one.